And then the niggas, they be hanging out right here too at this little gas station. It's run. Talking to y'all. Hold on. Yeah, the boy on ATL Scoop, he be dancing right there. So you forgot the muffin. I sure did, but I got something at the house. I'll be all right. Okay, so y'all, look. There's this show. Oh, shit. There's this show that's on, there's this show that's on Lifetime. Or you can go to, ooh, that tastes so good. Or you can go on demand. I don't know if y'all are from Georgia, but, it was this white guy who went to the elementary school. And he went to the elementary school and he stood the lady up in the office. And he was finna shoot the school up. It's crazy. It's called, something under fire. I gotta go look it up. That's the elementary school my son go to. I was so, girl, bitch, you was at the stop sign first, dummy. See, this is why I can't come out early in the morning. People don't know how to fucking drive in the morning. I don't like coming out in the morning. People just drive, girl. If you at the stop sign first, you're supposed to go first. I saw that. Yeah. Ooh, this tastes so good. Ooh, burnt my tongue. Yes, everybody can't drive in the morning. Okay, I'm about to have to get off in a second. Because we're getting close to my plans. They still waking up, friend. Child, I'm talking live, drinking. Everything, and I know what I'm doing. Okay, Under Fire, yes. Faith Under Fire, yes. Go on demand and watch Faith Under Fire. Y'all, that was so crazy. And that's my baby's school. I'm glad it didn't happen while he was there. I would have pushed up at that school and blew everybody up. The cops was taking too long to get up in there. I would have went there shooting up everything. I would have shot up him, the ceiling, everything. Get my baby out of here. The cops scared to go in. I don't give a fuck. Shoot that lady in the front. Don't shoot my child. I'm playing. Don't shoot her. Turn your camera off when you get close. Oh, no. I always park right here before I get to my house. I always park here and talk to y'all for a minute. Then I get off. I got to get home and go edit that video so I can upload it. When y'all get out to bed, I'm gonna upload like around 1 o'clock. Me and Quinn vlog from yesterday.
Oh boy, I love coffee.
They always wanna come when most of the people dead. Right, like bitch, kick that door down. It's only one of him. Like the lady was telling him it's one person. So if it's one person and all the kids are like secluded, they locked up, busting that school and shoot that motherfucker up. I think they was trying to protect the lady too. They didn't want her to get killed. So that's why they didn't rush in, because if they would have rushed in, they would have probably killed her. And so they was trying to save her life as well. And I understand that. Everybody life matters. So I get it, child. They didn't want her to die. Ooh, that got the back of my throat. Good God, got me. Ooh. Oh, let me show y'all. Hold on. I'm going to show y'all this place. Okay. So, look. Let me show y'all. And if anybody try to push up on me, I got my gun in my pocket. So, please don't try to push up and think you finna get me out here. Because I will blow your kneecap off. I'm not going to kill you, but I'll shoot your kneecap. Best believe I will. So, look. This is over here. Like near where I stay, right? And I used to run it in here with my dog. Can y'all hear me? Let me show y'all now. Is it okay? My gun is right here, so please don't come down here trying me. And if you don't believe me, come down here and try me. Okay. So look, this is where I used to run with my dog, right? Yeah, I couldn't kill nobody, but I definitely would shoot them in the kneecap or their foot just to slow them down from trying to get to me. But I couldn't kill nobody. It's just not in my blood. I can't. I don't see how, like, you know, the street niggas be killing each other and then they go to sleep. Like, I could never do that. Like, that's not on your conscience. You're not thinking about you took somebody's cousin, mama, daddy, and then, like, you really killed somebody. Like, it's not like you beat them up and blacked their eye or broke their nose. Like, you killed somebody. That is, you're weird. You need help. Okay. Did you close your door? Yeah. So, this is where I used to run with my dog, right? It's like a little hood. You know, all the men be down here during the day. But right now, it's still early. They done took the basketball goal down. The basketball goal used to be right there. There used to be so many men playing basketball. I used to just watch them. But anyway, so I used to run down here with my dog, right? Let me show you. I don't know why my stupid ass did this, but I used to run down here with my baby when he was a puppy. And child, my brother saw where I was running, and my real estate person saw where I was running, and they said, Zoe, you need to stop running down there by yourself. That's a cruise spot. I said, a cruise spot? So they be cruising out here, y'all. They be out here cruising. But they ain't gonna be able to do it too much longer because, look, they done fixed it up now, and now they finna make it look really nice. Because there used to be nothing but a lot of trees. So it was, like, you know, it was places for you to hide. Look, they, like, be jacking off on a little bench or having sex over there. It's a big-ass circle. And so now they done closed it off, and they done fixed it up. And mind you, they found a girl shot and dead out here. I said, oh, bitch, no, ma'am, I ain't running out here no more. So I don't run out here no more, girl. What's cruising? This right here. Look. That right there. They don't think they killed her out here, though. The light on. Go to Exchange Park, honey. It's over here on the east side. Go on out there. You will find somebody. I promise. They out there right now. I should take y'all over to let y'all see. Y'all gonna be like, ooh, he ain't lying. Locked it down. I have a whole gun, girl. No, I was running for real. I was running. I was out there trying to lose my stomach. I had a beer gut. They trying to play. I'm just trying to help my freaky people out, child. Let my freaky people know where to go. I'm letting my freaky people know where to go. Oh, y'all, this tastes so good.
Mm. Oh, boy, I love it.
Yeah, I'm in Georgia. Wait, what's the degrees outside? It's 46 degrees. That's cold to us. You said show y'all? Oh, bitch, I got on house shoes, friend. We gonna go one day. Look, let me see how far it is. Exchange part. Let me put it in. Hold on. It's not far from me, though. I used to go run. Oh, I loved running out there. Let me see. Exchange Park. Exchange Park. There you go. It's off Columbia Drive, Decatur, Georgia. I told you. Columbia Drive, Decatur, Georgia. Hell no. I want to move to Georgia. Is Marietta or McDonough better? Oh, they're both actually really good. But because I grew up in McDonough. They're both actually really good. Don't look at my ashy hands. But it depends on where you're working. I'm moving to Atlanta. Move to Atlanta, please, friend. Oh my God, I beat you every day. Okay, anyway, it depends on where you're working. Easy target, right? It depends on where you're working and what you do a lot. So if you like going to the city a lot, then you need to move to Marietta. You know what I'm saying? And then it's like, it's because they're both the same. Like the crime rate isn't, it's the same. Like it's not bad. It's not a lot of bullshit going on in either one of the places, but the traffic in both of the places are extremely high. Well, Atlanta just has a lot of high traffic anyway. But if you want to work downtown or go downtown, you live in Marietta. If you don't care about driving to the city, then live in McDonough. McDonough, your houses are going to be cheaper, to keep it real. Your houses are going to be cheaper. Your apartments are going to be cheaper. But you need to go now because McDonough's starting to build up. And it's gonna, the price is going to start going up in McDonough. But McDonough used to be really country and quiet. It's still country, but it's turning into like, what's that damn place called? Ah, shit. It's over there by Tucker. McDonough's growing up. It's looking good. Like, McDonough's looking really good now. It's gonna be really nice when they get everything out there. That's where everybody gonna start moving. Watch what I tell you. All them white folks gonna start moving. They're already there, but they really gonna go down. All them Duluth and Marietta folks, they gonna start moving to McDonough. Yeah, McDonough traffic is horrible, but the reason I like McDonough, because all you got to do, child, is get you that peach pass, and bitch, you're good. Bitch, you are good. We didn't say Griffin. We didn't say Griffin. We didn't say ratchet ass Griffin. Griffin is ratchet. said country. We didn't say Griffin. Ain't nobody going to Griffin. Oh, no. Griffin is ratchet, country, and just no. No, ma'am. We didn't say Griffin. You be booking without the pass? Yeah, I think if you go in the thing without the pass, it's probably like, what, $50 or something? But, child, I ain't giving y'all no free money. I got my pass. What about Dunwoody? Dunwoody's good, but, baby, I follow ATL Scoop. Mm-mm. All you got to do is follow ATL Scoop. ATL Scoop on Instagram, you know everything. Dunwoody it's a nice place, but it's expensive just because it's Dunwoody. And then it's just, I don't know, it's becoming ratchet. Like Buckhead and Dunwoody, all them places is becoming ratchet. It's like it's too many robberies up there now and window break-ins and child. I'm okay. I'm not moving to Buckhead. Middle of downtown, Dunwoody. No, I'm good. I am good. Midtown, yes. All the people, I don't know what's going on out there. But it's the teenagers. They too ratchet right now. They on go. they on X mode right now, girl. I'm good. They stealing your cars. I'm good. You go to the gas station, you turn around, leave your... this how bad it is. If you go to the gas station and leave your car running and you turn around and you doing your pump, if you didn't lock your doors, they hopping through your passenger seat and taking your car. I'm good. That's why I keep my keys like this. So when I get out my car, my keys ain't in that bitch. I don't know where you going. Edgewood... That's over here by me. I live near Edgewood. It just depends. If you're in Edgewood, good luck. Girl, I couldn't live in Edgewood, but around Edgewood, it's okay. But like in Edgewood, it's nice over there. I love the bars. I love the scenery, but it's just a lot. Girl. I mean, it's all in what you ready to deal with. It's what you want to deal with. They said zombies over there. Right. This dope ass out there, girl, walking. What about Decatur? Decatur is a good area, but it depends. Like, I live in DeKalb. DeKalb, they be shooting on Edgewood, right, but I still go. I live in DeKalb. DeKalb is actually really good. I think, like, the Bouldercrest area is good. The River Road area. You know what I'm saying? It's like it's certain areas that are good. Stockbridge is good. Yes, I think Stockbridge is good, but that's just too south for me. The reason I say Bouldercrest area is because no matter where you go, north, south, east, or west, everything is like the most 20 minutes from you in a car ride. So like if you're going downtown, 20 minutes, going to Six Flags, 20 minutes, going to the McDonough area, 25 minutes, 20 minutes. You know what I'm saying? Everything is like 20 minutes if you live in the Bouldercrest, DeKalb area, because you're smack dead in the middle. But Stockbridge is really nice. It's quiet. It's good. It's a lot of stuff out there. I like Stockbridge. But if you want to be in the middle of everything, I would say go to Bouldercrest, DeKalb area. You a Crip member, so is my friend. If you a Crip, I would say move towards Union City. A lot of Bloods live in Union City too, but a lot of Crips do too over there, you know, flat shows, S's, C's, and C's. Union City used to be really good too, but child, she hood too, honey. Union City is hood. But she used to, East Point's not bad, but I don't know. To be honest, if you look, like I said, if you're looking for a really nice, nice area, you gotta move on the outskirts. Like they said, McDonough, Stockbridge, Marietta, Duluth. Places like that where people don't wanna drive to. Places like that where people don't drive to and the city transit does not run. Girl, please. The city transit ain't running to Boulder. The city transit ain't running to McDonough, Stockbridge, Duluth. It ain't going to those places. You actually have Fayetteville ain't bad. You actually have to have a car to get out there. If you ain't got a car to get out there, you is not finna go to them places. But if it's like Decatur, Edgewood, Midtown, girl, it's fucking, it's too many transits, too many people, too much motion. Gwinnett's not bad. Covington isn't bad. I never heard of Canton. I heard of Dallas, but Dallas is the country. Don't nobody even mention Dallas, Georgia. Ooh, that's the country, sis. Ain't nobody coming to see you. Your own family members not coming to see you in Dallas, Georgia. Smyrna, nobody's coming to see you. Nobody. You can't even go to the club. Stone Mountain's not bad. Stone Mountain really isn't bad. I've never, you got your areas, but Stone Mountain ain't bad. I never really heard like a lot of bad stuff in the Stone Mountain. My aunt live out there. Morrow? No. Morrow, Georgia? No. Well, I guess it depends on what area. The area is near like South Lake Mall and all over there by South Lake and Clayton State University and what's that other little area? Ellenwood? No. That's them little kids who be thinking they in blood and they just ratchet. No, ma'am, girl. That's why South Lake Mall so binging them. Cause they just go to the mall and just stand there and look at each other and catcall on women. Morrow, I'm good. I am good off of Morrow. I'm good off of Morrow, honey. Y'all, we fool. What you mean, friend? Yeah, y'all, we full. Don't come here. We have enough people. It's enough. Like, the traffic is ridiculous. Like they said we are, like, compared to New York and L.A. now. Like, Atlanta traffic is... Cause I gotta go home and edit my video and I finished my little coffee. Cummings, I don't know, I never really go out there. It's far away, but I never heard nobody saying any bad things about Cummings, Georgia, but it's far, like, those are far places. So I feel like anywhere that's like far out, I feel like you're fine. Now, I don't know how racism is out there, but anything far out, like away from like transit areas and, you know, MARTA buses and all that, I feel like you're good because people don't have access to just come. But Zoe, send me a prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, I don't know why friend want a prayer, but whatever friend is going through, I ask you send friends peace, strength, and understanding to get through whatever it is they're going through. Let them know it's going to be okay because you got them through so many other things. But us as people tend to want you to do stuff right now. And we do stuff on your time. We don't understand that your time is the right time. But friend is going to get through it because you did that thing before and you did the thing before that thing. But we forget about the things you do. But guess what? When you do this for them now, they're going to say, oh, look at God. So give them the peace, give them the patience, and let them know you're going to get them through it. Amen and hallelujah. There you go, friend. And that was sincere and real. You knew I prayed for real because it was quick without stuttering. So you know I pray a lot. Oh! A person who don't pray a lot can't pray like that. They don't know what to say. They be bumbling. If you pray a lot, you go through them prayers, honey. But yeah, champ. They said, come on now. Oh, great man. You so would you ever come to South Africa? Oh my God. Westwood on my bucket list to go to Africa. I really have to go to Africa. I should have went. There is something going on in my nose. I should have went with my mama and them, but I was like, this when I was a teeny bopper and I was running the streets, child, trying to be grown. And I thought being with, you know, at the time you didn't understand, as a teenager, you didn't understand how important going to Africa was, child. So I was out here trying to run behind the niggas, being wild. And how important going to Africa was, child. So I was out here trying to run behind the nigga because they went to Ghana. And bitch, my ass stayed home. Now I'm grown and I'm like, bitch, I could have went to Ghana. Didn't understand how important that was back then. How long he been live? I've been live for a minute. I took Quinn to school at 7 something, so I've probably been live for an hour. But guess what? My lives be so good, child. These people always sitting here because these my friends. The reason they left, we had like 4,000, 5,000 people. The reason they left because we started talking about some bumbling. We're talking about Atlanta, so they want to hear that. But you know, my loyal's going to stay, child. But yeah, I've been live about an hour, honey. My conversations are always good. You never know what we're going to talk about or what we're going to encounter. Hello, somebody. I'm a comedian at heart, child. These folks be just putting on for y'all to make y'all think they funny. But anyway. Okay. Thug Out Tuesdays. Tell me more. Look at Thug Out Tuesdays was at a gay club. This is when I was a teenager. That's when I was hanging out with the sisters, girl. I wasn't really hanging out with the straight folks then. I used to date the DL men and the hood niggas, but I really, when I was like, you know, 15, 16, 17, 18, I was dating gay men then, like, you know, but masculine gay dudes who were saying that, because we really had more tops in Atlanta back then. People were actually tops. But now it's like, you know, since the world is opening up to this gay stuff, everybody has decided the term versatile or drag queens and transsexuals. But back then, when this stuff wasn't accepted like that, you had more masculine men. They probably was versatile then, but they was looked so masculine, they played it off. But anyway, somebody throwing up. I guess she must have looked at her mama walking down the steps in her panties and bra. I would, too, the way that body is shaped. But anyway, that ain't none of my business. She over here built up like a U-Haul truck. I would be mad, too. Mama, she built up like my coffee cup that her husband is upset about. But that's not my problem. Anyway, tell your mama put some clothes on so her children don't have to walk around upset and depressed going to school sad. Okay, but that ain't none of my problem. Anyway, so I was going to Thugged Out Tuesdays, and that was at the place called Tracks. And so, yeah, Thugged Out Tuesdays used to be real cool. But, you know, ain't no more thugs in Atlanta no more. Hello, somebody. So, yeah. Score. Now go puke on that. Go puke on that, mutant. Anyway, score. If it ain't about me, let's kiki. Y'all is so crazy. But yeah, child. We had tracks in DC. Y'all did? Yeah, we had a tracks here. 708 used to be thumping. Bulldogs is like the only gay club that still be thumping that all the kids go to. Oh, and they go, when gay people say kids, we don't mean like children. That's what the gay community call it. Like, the kids is out. They just say that. But I don't want people to think, oh my God, kids go to club? No. Bulldogs is where they still be thumping. And Marquette, those the only OG Atlanta gay clubs that still be hitting. Marquette just so ghetto, child. Hold on. You go to Marquette, you are going to see a fight. Like, you're going to see a fight. But Bulldogs, it's a bunch of older men. You gonna see sugar daddies in there. You gonna see old men who wanna like sugar baby. And you gonna get real drunk in Bulldogs too. They drinks be on point. Go to the white man in the middle. He gonna get you fucked up. Like, he gonna get you fucked up. The kids and the girls means gays. Yes, that's what we say. Like, the kids is out, the girls is out. But go to the white man in the middle at Bulldogs who be making like 20 drinks at one time. Bitch, it's worth the wait because that one cup gonna fuck you up. You gonna be like, oh, Jesus, what did he give me? You gonna think he put a pill in your drink. What about the guys that came over with the infections? Ooh, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know nothing about no. But how you know about it? Because I don't know nothing about no. I don't know nothing about no infection. You got it, sis. That's your area. I don't know nothing about none of that. Nothing about none of that. That's your stomping ground. Uh-oh. Ooh, who is that? Where he going? Oh, his Uber done let him out. When I be seeing men get out of Uber early in the morning, I be thinking they be leaving from like a date house. Like, they just left a date house. Because I know I be shipping my little dates off in Ubers in the morning. I be like, I'm not taking you home. Like, the only way I take somebody home if they spent the night is if, like, it was just bussing. Like, if it was bussing, I'm gonna take you home. But if it was just like, you know, if you like a little sneaky link and I don't know where it's going, I'm gonna Uber you home. I'm gonna treat you like a sneaky link. But if it's giving like, oh, this dick is loyal dick. Oh, this is lock him down dick. Oh, bitch, I'm taking you home, child. I want you to know it's real. Bitch, I'm getting up 8 o'clock, take you home. I don't care if you live an hour away. You ready? Are you need breakfast? Bitch, you will wake up in my bed to some food already DoorDashed before you get up. What? I didn't cook it, but your stomach is full. Child, please, don't play with me. I'll make you feel like a king, child. I surely will. Something. Little apple juice or something. You want a little apple juice or something? Y'all is stupid, child. Yeah, I don't do Uber Eats no more. I used to love Uber Eats, but I really feel like DoorDash is a whole lot better. Their customer service is better. They actually put the food where you tell them to. feel like their service fees are a little higher, but it's okay when you have good customer service. My food beyond. So they ran, got in her car, took her car, and she was over it, child. So Uber Eats start cutting they delivery off at like 9-10 o'clock. Bitch, you be wanting Uber Eats at 11 and 12. Bitch, the fuck? You cutting shit up at 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock? I'm not even hungry yet. I ain't even got drunk from the club. Fuck is you talking about? So, yeah, that's when I deleted it and got DoorDash. And I really like DoorDash. I really like DoorDash a lot. And they be really friendly. They be talking to you, too, in them text messages. I tried to date one of the dudes who was, The only thing I don't like is I can't see who my DoorDash delivery is. See, with Uber Eats, I could see who my person was before they got there so I could make sure if they was cute. I wanted to make sure I had on a nice pair of clothes, some small shorts, or whatever the case may be. But with DoorDash, I can't see who coming. I just see the name. So what I try to do is I try to text them to see how they conversate and how they text. You know, if he texts like A-I-I, which means alright, they be like, alright, we on the way. I'm like, ooh, this a hood nigga, let me put some shorts on. But if I see like a name like Josiah and he texts like, great, your order will be there, they're taking a little bit long, I'm like, oh girl, drop it off at the door, I'll come get it. I didn't know what the fuck going on, who I'm finna see, child. I be wanting to know. I be looking at my ring light. I be looking at my Nest light doorbell, waiting for you to come drop the food. I'll see what you looking like if I need to go rush down the steps or something. Child, I don't be wanting to do that. That's the only thing I don't like about DoorDash. I want to see who the fuck coming to my house. I want to know. But I don't know, child. And I used to see, I left everything Uber. I left Uber Eats and I left Uber. I used to really love Uber, but I forgot what happened. I left them. Oh, I know what happened. I was in, where was I at? Some country town. And they didn't have Uber, but they had Lyft. So I downloaded Lyft and I was like, ooh, I like Lyft. Because Lyft is so cute. Like all the little chimes, the ding, ding, ding. And then it buzzes when they like 3 minutes from your house. And then like, it's just a lot of stuff that go on with Lyft. Like I like Lyft. It's just, I like it. And then when I tweeted it out, they gave me like $200 worth of rides, girl. I said, I know you fucking lie. So they gave me $200 worth of rides for Lyft, child. And honey, I've been using Lyft ever since. But the only thing I don't like about Lyft that be pissing me off sometimes is, bitch, you can book Lyft and then, baby, you think your car coming and then, like, they done threw you off to somebody else. They done passed you around like a hot hoe to four niggas in 2 minutes. And I'm like, bitch, what fucking car am I getting in? Who picking me up? Because at this point, I don't even know who the fuck I'm riding with. That's the only thing I don't like. They'll throw you off on somebody else because they're trying to put whoever closest to you. But, bitch, at this point, I don't care who close to me. Just put me with somebody. Bitch, y'all got me over here throwing me around like I'm just an easy hoe. I ain't easy. I don't need everybody seeing my profile. Need everybody seeing my damn profile. What's wrong with you? I don't know her. I'll ask for you. But that's the only thing I don't like. But other than that, I love it. It's so nice. The colors. It's just like everything is just there. And like you could preset rides and add on rides and tell them who riding. And it's just a lot. I don't know. I just like it. I feel like the locations are more accurate on Lyft. Like on Uber, you could put a location in and bitch, they behind your house at the stop sign. It's like, bitch, where you at? It's like all the Uber drivers are just slow. Like, bitch, where the fuck you at? I ain't never had to tell a Lyft person where I am. They just pop up. Bitch, they know where I'm at before I'm there. Oh, you there? Oh, I know how to come around. I say about 10 minutes. Oh, all right, bitch. Come on, ho. What's wrong with you? Let's go. And they don't be caring about all that other shit either. Lyft people don't really talk like that. Uber people just be talking, 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 talking. Lyft people don't talk like that. They just be trying to get you where you need to go. Good, sis. I ain't trying to talk anyway. All right, y'all, let me go. We've been here for a little too long. But I love y'all. He talking about Lyft versus Uber. Yeah, honey. All right, y'all. I love y'all. Let me go. We've been talking for a minute. I gotta go home and edit this video. Put it up by 1 o'clock. Uber drivers is annoying and they want to hold conversations. Right. Thank y'all for listening. This was a great little morning convo. Hope y'all have a good day. Get your coffee. Go take your children to school. If your children didn't go to school, hope they're doing something at home productive. Okay, bye.